It's mailbag time. Bunch more stuff showed up. Let's see what I ordered, because I can't remember. It was months ago when I ordered this stuff. All right. First thing up, what have I got? Electronic components, value $3.12. Which is okay. That's actually fairly expensive by my ordering cheap stuff from China standards. What we got here? Oh, that looks interesting. Some kind of a kit. So what do we have here? ZIF socket, circuit board, some header pins, 10-pin connector, pushy button latching, pushy button momentary. It's getting a little bit closer here. Tilt just a little bit so we can see. There we go. Crystal, 8-meg crystal, USB, capacitors, LEDs, resistors. Hey, that is everything you need to make an Arduino. Yeah, that, I'm fairly confident that guy fits the full size dip. 18 mega 328. Oh yeah. That's what that is. Basically the kit to make that. 18 mega 8, 18 mega 48, 88 development board, AVR. Oh. That's interesting. None of those say 18 mega 328. Did I make a oops? Oh well, it's I bought it at auction for an entire $168 Canadian. And let's cruise down here and see what we got. Yeah, 18 mega of 8 or 48 or 88. I may have made an error and wasted a whole less than $2. Gee, oops. But I got parts. That's fine too. I'll have to do some researching. Anyway, supply voltage, 8 meg crystal, blah, 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 all that. 28 pin locking seat, which I guess is the ZIF socket. DC 3-10 horns seat. That'll be that little 10 pin connector. Crystal, some ceramic capacitors, buttons, resistors, all the things that you need to make something Arduino-ish. I can play with that. Next thing, electronic components. Also $3.12. Huh. Interesting. What did I just run over there? Oh ho! Pair of cutters. Get out of there. Pair of flush cutters specifically. Complete with a bit of factory oil on them. So, flush cutters. Why do I want flush cutters instead of, say, traditional old side cutters? Actually, those ones are fairly flush too, but not perfectly flush. Let me zoom in a little bit here. So here is your typical side cutters. This isn't smooth, so when you're cutting a lead off or cutting a tie wrap or zip tie, whatever, let's zoom back out a little bit. So when you're cutting one of these guys off, let's put it around there just for fun. When you're cutting it with an old school cutter, it doesn't get perfectly flush. It leaves see the little tail hanging out. Now when you're reaching your arm in somewhere into a bundle, past a bundle of wires, that is going to cause some significant pain and potentially blood loss. But when you use a pair of flush cutters, nice and smooth, no danger. That's why I always use flush cutters at work. I've got one set that I've had forever. This set was fairly cheap on eBay, and because you know that's just how I roll. So I figured I'd grab that just to have. I mean, they're good for cutting component leads off off the back of the circuit board after you've soldered stuff up too. Obviously, they're wire cutters, but that you don't need necessarily to go super duper flush. These old guys work if they weren't horrendously dull. Oh man, can you see? Yeah, that's yet another reason that these are a bad idea, but these were cheap and they were ancient. I've had these since I was a teenager, says the really old man. So they're still good if you need to cut something where you're concerned about damaging these other ones. So there you go. That's going to be useful. Durable electrical wire cable cutter, cutting plier, side snips, flush pliers. The important part here is cutter and flush. From GC Supermarket, who I've ordered a bunch of stuff from in the past. $245 Canadian. And yeah. That is exactly the same one that I got. Which is nice. Sometimes you order stuff and it comes in a different color or it's slightly different. I'm sure there's not much to say about this down here. No, brand new, high quality, lightweight, thin profile. Yeah. Okay. Oh, this one I actually know who it's from. 21 or 2012 top deal. And 1x LED. Doesn't look like LEDs because it isn't. This is an assortment pack of different shapes and sizes of tactile switches. These super tiniest guys tend to be the ones that are the reset button on the smaller Arduino type boards. That's those, and so those and those are specifically set up for surface mount. So are these ones. These ones are the same shape as these ones, only in through hole. And these ones are also set up as through hole, but with ridiculously long shafts. That'll come in handy. More stuff for stock, if nothing else. They're not, a lot of these things, when I buy multiples of components, they're not for a specific project. They are just to have in stock for when I decide to make something and I don't want to have to wait the 6 weeks to 6 months for them to show up from China. So, and they were cheap. These might have actually been part of an auction, which would have made them even cheaper. Have to look. 100 pieces, 5 types, momentary, tactile, push button switch, SMD assortment kit set. Alright, from 2012 top deal, another one that I've ordered from in the past, $1.78 Canadian. Ooh, I got a discount of 7 cents on this one. Free shipping all the way from China as usual. So yeah, it's just showing the 5 different types, which we kind of saw already. So there's some surface mount and some through hole. Excellent. Okay, description of contents. 10 of those and 2 of those. Worth $10, they say. Ooh, crinkly noise. Drive your cats nuts. Okay. Aha! Okay, so these are a similar concept to the Wago terminals that I really like to use just for making temporary connections. Only these guys are 2 connections. As you push that down, it pushes down a little springy clip. And on the other end, and there we go. You can see, when you push down, it just pushes down the little spring clip on the end. So those, I'll probably use them for on the workbench just as a test connector. I doubt that they're considered to be a permanent connection, but we'll see. Again, shop stock. You never know when you're going to need to be able to connect wires to things. Let's not throw those bare wires right into that, shall we? Okay. Let's see where I got those from. So for the quick connectors, I couldn't find the exact listing that I bought it from. I bought it at an auction. I got it for cheap. Can't remember exactly. But here is the same seller who is currently auctioning the same thing off. Oh, yeah, I wrote it down. I got them for 99 cents. And after shipping, this particular one has shipping paid on it. Paid shipping 61 cents. So you got to figure that in. But to the one that I bought was free shipping and worked out to 99 cents Canadian. There we are. 10 times electrical cable connectors. Quick splice lock wire terminal self-locking T from Wonderful Buying 36588. Are there any specs on it at all? White, female. There we go. It can take 0.2 square millimeter up to 2.5 square millimeter. I'm not sure what that is in AWG, but it's relatively wide. It claims to be able to handle 250 volts, 10 amps. Not sure if I'm going to stress it that hard or not. I'm guessing no. Next up is electronic components. I love these surprises. You never know what you're going to get, even though they are described. Two bags of, keychainable, micro SD USB 2.0, it says on it. Okay, yeah, that's USB. Oh, they're just USB SD card adapters. Okay. So, take a micro SD card. That's it. That's not very positive. Is it going further? Oh, okay. Okay. Well, let's see what happens. Okay, plugged in there. Oh, would you look at that? Open in File Manager. Okay. Ah, yeah, that's cool. There's the music that I was using for testing those MP3 players a few weeks ago. Cool. 10 pieces, new high-speed USB 2.0 mini micro SD T-Flash TFM2 memory card reader. I got them at auction for $1.66 for the 10 of them. That's why I bought 10, because it was an auction and it was cheap. From GC Supermarket, another one of my regular purchasers. Not much to say about these that I didn't already say. Supports USB 1.1 or 2 and micro SD SDHC 2.0. Plug and play, hot swapping, pretty much standard for cheap SD card USB adapters. Except for instead of paying a buck for one at my local dollar store, I paid $1.66 for 10 of them from the opposite of local. Okay, next up we have can't tell. Bad post office. Bad. Where'd that come from? Somebody whose name I don't recognize. Oh, that's a fairly good sized box, though. Oh, it's one of these. I saw a few people doing reviews of these, and for a ridiculously cheap camera, they were actually reviewed quite well. That's cool. Okay, so there's all the accessories. There is the camera. That claims to be a full 1080p HD camera, complete with infrared illuminators, complete with a battery inside it. Runs on micro SD, it's a teeny tiny USB connector. It doesn't matter how teeny tiny and possibly non-standard it is. It comes with that. Comes with its very own connector. Let's get that white thing out of the way so I'm not quite so out of balance. That's because that is actually, yeah, this is the micro SD, such as pretty much every phone has on it. And there's the super extra tiny micro SD or USB that this guy wants for charging. Okay, that's cool. I'm gonna have to play with this some and probably do a full standalone video on just that guy. What do we got with it here? Little clip that looks like it clips on there, and okay, so I can clamp it onto something, and no, not something so smooth as a coffee cup, I guess. Clamp it onto something and have it just look around. Or there's this thing. Oh, okay. So it looks like that. You can screw it or glue it or something on to stuff. And then just clip that clip onto there. And aim it wherever you want. That's kind of neat. Oh, I have an application for this. Hang on. There's what I'm going to use it for. At least one of the things I'm going to use it for. Touring my model railroad, because that is basically the same height as the engineer's cab view. That's gonna be interesting. It also means I'm gonna have to up my scenery game a whole bunch, because looking from that angle is really gonna show off any and all of the flaws. But that's gonna be a really cool view. Especially if I load up the tracks on either side of it and I'm cruising through the yard. Oh, I like that. But before I get to doing that, I'm going to have to charge the battery, spend some time translating the manual into a language that I can read, watch some other videos who have reviewed this and already figured it out, so I don't have to think that hard. Because, oh man, it has LEDs, it has mini USB. Oh! Okay, I'm an idiot. TV out, built-in lithium battery, can sustain camera up to 100 minutes. 100 minutes, a little over an hour and a half, okay. Can insert digital volt near DV 5 volt charger while external record. Interesting. Don't know what that means exactly. How to reset it if a machine crashes. Oh, if you put 5 volts on her, it jumps straight into 720 video mode. No manual stop has been recorded. Oh, it's got a motion detect mode. It's got an infrared. Yeah, kind of thought those four LEDs around there were infrared illuminators. That's cool. So AVIM JPEG, 720 or 1080, 30 frames per second. Ooh, 4:3 ratio. So that's not going to be the wider screen video that you're watching in. That's going to be kind of that shape. So you'll know when I'm using it. Okay, matters needing attention. Pretty strictly abide by the relevant national laws. Product may not be used for any illegal purposes. Working temperature, please use under natural temperature. Do not work in the human body. Okay, I don't even want to think about that too much. Anyway, I'm going to do a full video on this thing separately, and after I've had a chance to play with it for a week or so. And yeah, I can't guarantee it's going to be this coming week, but well, maybe. Depends on how busy I am, I guess. Anyway, let's take a peeky look at where I bought this thing from. So the camera, it cost me $8.72 plus 24 cents shipping, so what's that, about $9 for a teeny tiny HD camera. That's pretty cool. It came in a little over a month. That's good. For some reason, I can't find the actual listing, but I happened to get it from Cook's SX5. And yeah, as I said earlier, I'll be playing with that for a week or so and do a proper video about just this guy. And there you go. That's all this episode's mailbag stuff. This should be interesting. I've got a kind of project kit, some stockpile for stock, and this neat little cheap camera to play with. Oh, and those. I don't know why I was fondling those while I was talking to you, but got that too. Talk to you later.